Torrential rain and severe flooding continues to grip parts of New South Wales tonight.
Record downpours have forced evacuations and emergency rescues and closed transport links. To the south of Sydney, Illawarra residents are facing a large clean-up. We'll get the latest from Lachlan Kennedy at Albion Park. And farther south, Biegers River has risen to levels not seen in more than 30 years.
John Hill has spent the day there and joins us now from the SES headquarters at Maruya. That's north of Bega. John, just how serious has this flooding been?
Bill, this was a major flood for this area. Bega had 134 millimetres of rain in the 24 hours to 9 o'clock this morning. Premier Christina Keneally has declared a natural disaster in the Illawarra, Kiama, Shell Harbour and Bega. But it's not over yet for the people of Bega because there's still a lot more bad weather in the area.
A downpour in the upper reaches of the Bega Valley sent torrents of water downstream. The Bega River broke its banks, and as floodwaters rose, residents were forced out of their homes. And Grant was evacuated last night. Today there was a metre of water through her house.
I went out the back to go to the toilet and the toilet was flooded, and then it just rolled into the kitchen and then it rolled into the lounge room, and I just rang the SES and they come down and got me. So
about a dozen homes have been flooded here. Warwick Lemon was hoping he'd escape the heartbreak of being flooded, but the waters rose just above his floorboards.
We didn't get any stuff, we just pulled fridges off the floor and such, and TVs, put them on the benches and tables, and yeah. No, it just come up too quick.
Locals say the floodwaters started coming up extremely quickly around 11 last night, trickling into the backyards in low-lying areas. But by 3 this morning, it was flowing through homes.
The ambulance station was underwater, but ambulance officers were still on the job. One of Bega's two petrol stations was flooded and the highway cut, but diversions were in place. Police are also investigating an alleged case of looting after a man and two children were found with food items that had floated from the service station shop. Elsewhere, residents who couldn't see the river from their homes awoke to a menacing water view. And although families are confident the river won't rise further, they're still sandbagging just in case.
So we shifted a few things. Then at, I'd say, 2 o'clock, there'd be 5 or 6 feet of water in the backyard. I was up to my waist trying to shift stuff.
In Bega, they're hoping this flood has reached its peak, but locals are keeping a close eye on the weather. John Hill, 10 News.